Hey, Brett McFall here with the next Uncommon View. Thank you for watching. And I want to talk today about someone who's actually in your life. Now, I'm not psychic, but I suspect I know somebody who's in your life. And that person is called Aunt Sally. Do you have an Aunt Sally? You might be saying no. Well, I'll tell you this. Even if you don't have an Aunt Sally, you have an Aunt Sally. Let me explain. And I do this live in my seminars where I really demonstrate it and I talk about it at length. And I want to share it with you here because it's a really important thing to understand when it comes to being successful, when it comes to doing what you want to do, when it comes to living your life's dream, when it comes to you just being 100% in the moment. This concept is pretty vital. Okay. So Aunt Sally, who is Aunt Sally? Let me see if you have an Aunt Sally. Aunt Sally is the person who has a problem for every solution. All right, so every solution you provide, Aunt Sally has a problem with it. He or she, it could be Uncle Sally, don't forget. But Aunt Sally, we'll use that as a term, is that person in your life who doesn't quite see things the way you do and doesn't quite believe in it as much as you do. And that sort of person where, you know, if you were to come to my seminar about internet marketing as I show you my systems, that person, you don't even tell them that you're going. That's Aunt Sally. And if they do happen to come along, sometimes they come along to my events. I try and keep them out of the room because they're just bad news, right? Bad attitude, cynical, very disbelieving. And so there's no space for those people inside my seminar rooms. Go and annoy somebody else because you're not going to, I don't want you in the room, you know, stopping these people who want to learn from learning. So Aunt Sally is that person who in your life who, you know, is doubting, asks a lot of questions, and questions are good, mind you. But it's the questions like, oh, do you think that's really going to work? I mean, is that a great question? Do you think that's really going to work? That's a question that's loaded, all right, where it makes you doubt what you're doing, what you're believing, where you're going. Maybe you're married to Aunt Sally, and it could be, you know, your husband or your wife. You could be going out with Aunt Sally, a boyfriend or girlfriend. Your Aunt Sally could be your family, could be a whole bunch of people. You might have a whole bunch of people who are, let's say this, they are people who are interested in having a better life, in doing more things, in being happy. They're interested in being happy, but they don't particularly want to actually experience it. It's like, it's too much. They would say things like, you know, never aim too high, because that way you won't be as disappointed when you fail. Okay, never aim too high. And so, I personally have to battle all these people online, in my seminars, where they just want to make sure that we all keep this realistic now, right? We keep it all realistic. Let's make sure we don't dream too much. What you're saying there, oh, it sounds too hypey, because we don't want to go too far, right? Now, let me tell you about Aunt Sally. Aunt Sally can be a very dangerous, influential person in your life. And I've had people in my life who also have been Aunt Sally, and I let them affect me for enough time for me to get pissed off about it, so I didn't listen to them anymore. And I want you to get to that level too, where you don't listen to them and you just follow your own path. Now, listening's good, by the way. Listening's good, but it's about managing what you listen to and how you interpret what you listen to. So it's about being aware that, okay, out there, there's a whole bunch of Aunt Sallys. There's more Aunt Sallys out there than there are, you know, motivational, positive people out there pushing you along. So, you know, you've got to battle against this. We all do. I do. You do. So if we know an Aunt Sally is out there, what do we do? We just give up and we just say, you know what? You're probably right. Yeah, probably won't work. Yeah. I don't want to make a mistake. I don't want to get in trouble. I don't want to lose money. And so, you know, if Aunt Sally gets in your head, you find yourself saying these things. Yeah, you're right. Yeah, I won't get involved in that because it could go wrong. What if it goes wrong? Yeah, what if it doesn't work out? You know, all these sort of BS questions, which are questions, but they're totally loaded. They're totally overreactive. You know, if you're going to ask a question like, what if it doesn't work? Then you should instantly ask the question, well, what if it does? Because that instantly balances up the equation so you can make a balanced decision. You know, I'm into positive thinking. I think it's very important to be positive, to be seeing what things can be done, the success that can come, what you could do rather than what you can't do. Very, very into that. And it's almost, I think it's vital. I think it's actually imperative to be actually having a happy life. It's seeing what's good about things rather than what's bad. It's easy to see the bad stuff. It's hard to see the good stuff. So I'm into that. But, you know, not to the degree where I'm saying, you know, brainwash yourself into thinking everything's fantastic. No. That's not what this is all about at all. It's about balancing up the equation so that if somebody in your life asks you, you know, a negative focus question, a harming question, a pain-inducing question, It's about balancing it up. You know, like I get a lot of people say, let's give you an example, like people who come to, say, my seminars to learn about online marketing have partners who don't really want them to be there, and when they do go, they give them grief for going there. They don't support them, and so those partners come along, those people come along to my seminars, and they're saying, oh, if you only met my husband, oh, if you only met my wife, oh, if you met the people I got to work with, you know. And so ultimately, it doesn't really matter who those people are, they're all having the same influence. So what do you do about that? What do you do about it? You know, what do you do? Do you just lie down, or do you do something about it? And you know as well as I do, you've got to do something about it, right? You've got to do something about it. You've got to stand up, and you've got to be counted. So are you going to do that? Are you going to stand up to see what you believe in, to try things out? Because no one can force you to do what you don't want to do. No one can force you to do what you don't want to do, including how you feel. No one can change how you feel. No one can take away your excitement. You allow that to happen. That's a pretty big concept, right? And maybe you need to delve a bit more into those sort of concepts, because it's very powerful, but it's absolutely true. So what do you do about it? What do you do, man? What are you going to do about the Aunt Sallys in your life? What are you going to do? You're going to let them win? You're going to let them take the wind out of your sails? Or are you going to keep on pushing? What does it take to be successful? Does it take you to be a person who listens to all the negative people and agrees with them? Or does it take you to be somebody who steps out and says, you know what, I hear it, I understand your point of view, I'm going to try it anyway. I'm going to try and make the best decisions I can along the way, and we'll see how we go. You know, I have some people come to me, Brett, and say, you know, how can you guarantee I'm going to make money online? How can you guarantee I'm going to make money online? And I can't, and I won't. It's like, how can we guarantee that tomorrow is going to be sunny? How can we guarantee that? Well, you can't. You just got to wait for tomorrow to turn up, right? You can make predictions. How can we guarantee that your government is going to make the right decisions in terms of your economy? How can we guarantee that the cars on the road that you're driving beside are not going to hit your car, not going to drive into your car? How can you guarantee that people are not going to walk into your path as you're driving your car? You know, so we keep on asking these questions, can't we? And if you're searching for guarantees, don't get into business. Don't get into business if you're searching for guarantees, because it takes faith. It takes faith. It takes you to be able to resist the negativity, resist the person who doesn't believe in you, and say, okay, I hear you, I understand, but I'm going to go ahead anyway. That's what it takes. If you're not ready for that, don't think about starting a business or going anywhere near a business, all right? In fact, you know, that little principle there would affect your life greatly, not just business-wise, but everywhere, you know. Maybe you're for the person who resists going into a room full of people because you're afraid of what people might say, maybe they might judge you. You know, all this, they're all Aunt Sallys. In your mind, they're all Aunt Sallys. You know, so this really is quite a big issue, which affects every part of your life. You know, I let it affect me for a good 5 to 10 years, somewhere in that range, because I'd go and see an accountant when I was in a job. I'd go and see an accountant to ask him more questions about starting business. Now, what about this? Well, now, what about that? What if this happens? Now, the person, the accountant, answered all the questions, but it also just made me fearful, because it was all based around what if it doesn't work. That was the underlying crux of my questions and then his answers. It was like, what if it doesn't work? Well, you can do this, this, and this. So, you know, whenever you focus on what could go wrong, you'll never take action. You know, you'll always do more to avoid pain than you will to gain pleasure. You'll always do more to avoid pain than you will to gain pleasure. So, harden up. Step up. Be the person who leads the way. Remember, if you're going to lead the crowd, you're going to get some arrows in your back. It's going to happen. Guaranteed. I can guarantee you that. There are people who will disagree with you and won't like what you're doing. But you know what? If you're not sticking your head out, you won't get criticized. So, you know, if you don't want to be criticized, don't want to actually achieve anything, then stay doing what you're doing, but then realize you won't get criticized and you'll be fine, you'll be happy. Or choose to say, you know what? I've got a short life. This is a very short life we all live. And tomorrow's promised to no one. You never know when this life is over. So I say, make the most of it. Make the most and be the best you can be. What do you say? All right? If you're ready to, stand up to the Aunt Sallys in your life, then do it. Do it right now. Decide right now. This is it. I've had enough. I am going to do it anyway. Okay? I'm Brett McFall. This is The Uncommon View. That's my view. Let me hear yours. Talk soon.